In today's tutorial, we're going to learn how to make this cool and neat HD vector background using Adobe Illustrator. This HD vector background is perfect for any web-based use. Also, sponsoring today's video is Template Monster, and they have an awesome announcement where you can enter a 7-week masterclass to learn how to set up your very own design business online, totally for free. So learn how to enter into that great opportunity later in today's video. In Illustrator, the first thing we need to do for our HD vector background is to make a HD document. So take note of the pixel measurements that I'm using, and we're also going to be working RGB and with a 72 PPI setting. This is because our design is meant for web-based use. The very first thing we need to do in today's background tutorial is to select the gradient fill and make a box off to the side with the rectangle tool, the shortcut being M on your keyboard. We're going to want to choose a grayscale gradient, much like I'm using here. And we want to leave this box here to refer back to at any stage, because this gradient style is going to be the original style we use throughout. This is an example of non-destructive workflow. Then press P for the pen tool and draw a shape like mine here. We're going to build up a HD vector background with random shapes like this. And don't worry if your pen tool curve isn't smooth or perfect, because I have a quick solution for that next. Connect the path with the pen tool, and then take the smooth tool here. This is going to allow you to smoothen out the curves so they're fluid and natural. Once happy with the shape, apply a drop shadow like I'm doing here. And for this HD document, these are the settings that I'm using for the drop shadow. As you can see, that has added a nice drop shadow effect to my shape. You need to build up your background with multiple shapes of this nature, and next I'm going to show you how to overlay a perfect color gradient with a neat little trick. If you're enjoying today's HD vector background tutorial and you're finding it useful, let me know in the comment section below. So here is my background so far, and it looks a little messy, but that's fine because we're going to clean it up soon. But first, remember you can take the smooth tool at any time to iron out the curves and make them more fluid. Press M for the rectangle tool and carefully draw around the entire canvas, exactly on the edge. Having the smart guides activated in Illustrator will help with this. The color of the rectangle should be the same as the gradient we've used throughout the entire tutorial, and then send it to the very back. Press Command or Control C to copy the rectangle, and it might be wise to lock it down in place so it doesn't move around. Then press Command or Control F to duplicate the rectangle exactly in position, and then make sure it's at the very front. Now click and drag to select everything, and then Control or right click the selection and choose a clipping mask. This is going to cut everything below the rectangle into the shape of the rectangle. But everything is linked together, so to separate the shapes, go into the Pathfinder window and choose the Trim option. Then go up to Object and Ungroup. You can now edit each individual shape for your HD vector background. So finally, we're going to add some color to our design, and to do this, first press Command or Control F, which is going to paste the rectangle from earlier. To add some color, open up the gradient window and simply change the two colors. Obviously, you can use whatever colors you want to, but try and make them blend in harmony. Now, the key step here is to open up the transparency window and then experiment with different blend modes. I found that for my design, using hard light was the most fitting setting, and then I lowered the opacity to allow the vector background to show through in a more prominent manner. So next, I'm going to show you how you can make your very own design studio in a 7-week business masterclass with Template Monster. Template Monster sponsored a previous video on this channel, and they're back here again today to offer you a great opportunity where you can actually enter a 7-week marathon online as a means to learn how to set up your very own design business on your computer. All you need to do is enter your email address via the link in the description below, and Template Monster accepting applications until June the 18th, which is when the 7-week masterclass is going to start. So if you want to learn how to build websites, set up a design team, learn about working in a team in harmony, as well as the legal side of running a business online, check out the link in the description below and sign up for free before June the 18th. There are unlimited spaces and it is totally free to enter, and you should check out the links in the description below for information on exactly how to enter. However, I feel that it's a great opportunity for you all to learn a few things about conducting business online, specifically a design type of business. So let me know if you found today's tutorial useful, and if you enjoyed the video in general. I should be back tomorrow with a final video of the week. Of course, subscribe to Satori Graphics if you do find my content useful. Drop a like and share this video online if you really do find my content useful and you want to help out the channel. Also remember to check out Template Monster via the link in the description below. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.